you're thinking all the time and you're teaching all the time based on what you think you are. And that lends yourself to come to more of a purification of that thinking. So that your attitude is loving and open and gentle, and you know, those are the characteristics of, you know, the teacher of God, those kind of attributes and traits, that really you can feel the presence through that. So, and for me that's been the thing. I was in Roscoe one time, and I was in the community kitchens, and I walked in, and there was a woman in there that was seemingly complaining and judging and complaining and judging, and one by one, the people just leaving the kitchen. Although I was really engaging with her, where I was really just joining with her beyond that, you know, just really tuning in with her and beyond the surface stuff. And then, little by little, one by one, everybody left, and we were the only two left. And it actually was turned into quite a joyful experience, and then I saw her later on in my travels. Then when I traveled around to other places in Roscoe, Foundation, they would say, I learned more from watching you with that woman in the community kitchen than I did from the lectures in the main lecture place. Because the lectures were just about the metaphysics and just about the teachings. Mm-hmm. But the demonstration was what they really felt they learned more from. They were more inspired by, you know, just kind of seeing past all that stuff. And in the end, that's the part that really sticks in your mind, is when you feel inspired by something, or you feel joy and open-mindedness and non-judgmentness. Oh yeah, that's attractive. No doubt about that.
But that's what they get you on all the time, like in Endeavor, don't they? It's always, they accuse anyone who's speaking as being a conceptualizer, and they're beyond conceptual. Concepts. Did they kind of say something like that last night?
Yeah, that's been a common thing. But the Course is many different kind of ideas and concepts, and there's at one point where it's like salvation's task is exchanging concepts, so the Holy Spirit has to help you approach forgiveness or atonement, which is still a concept because it wasn't created. But it's the highest concept, and so you kind of keep exchanging self-concepts. Maybe you start off as, I'm a man, or a woman, and I'm a worker, and I'm a mother, or a brother, or a sister, or whatever. Then the more you start to go into it, it's more like this teacher of God concept starts to come in. And then you have to unlearn that one too, because that's just a stepping stone idea. Mm-hmm. You know, just as he says, the teacher and the learner are really one, they're really the same, and it's just the mind going through a conversion process. So it's just important to be willing to not just cling to any concepts, like to think, I'm on a rung of the ladder and I like it here, I'm just going to camp out, and as Jesus is always, push, keep pushing, higher, higher, higher. That's what's great.
The Course says you don't have to be without impure thoughts, but you have to be willing to let them go.
Yeah, right.
You can't keep them. They don't have to be perfect.
So do you think that Marianne Williamson is likely to come closer to Course concepts, perhaps, now that she feels free to do that? Or? And she's also left that church of today, too, so there's another... got her own podium now, I guess, right?
Yeah, that's the thing when you seem to be involved with an organization or a church or whatever. For Marianne, she was very much of an autonomous lecturer going wherever, and then yearning for a spiritual home. And then Church of Today seemed to suit that, but then again you have a board of directors telling you what you can and can't do, and in the end, organized religion is an oxymoron or a contradiction of terms, because you can't organize the present moment. As much as the mind may try to, you know, like he says in the workbook, you know, if you try to activate the past, you know, organize the present or plan the future, You know, he says in lesson 135, then, you know, you're missing. So that's quite a thing. Okay. Trust here. No activating the past, no organizing the present, no planning the future. You're winging it.
I've got a friend who he's been going down to church today when he attends to see Marianne, and she writes to me emails every once in a while about how it's changed. Well, since she's left, the attendance at church today has gone precipitously dropped. I mean, it's like half of what it used to be when Marianne was there. And Marianne is doing something, not on a regular basis, but maybe once a month or so in Detroit, and apparently packing them in. You know, so it's like the success she had there has kind of followed her, so it's kind of an interesting phenomenon. Yeah.
It's more inroads, mm-hmm. just like the Jerry Jampolsky's books, Marianne. They've been used in the plan for people to hear about A Course in Miracles.
To the course, right?
Now, as far as actually taking a lot deeper, it goes so much deeper than that, but everybody... It's all maximal. Everybody's got to start somewhere.
There have to be bridges.
There has to be bridges. And mm-hmm. it's so, I always see how it's everything's serving the plan perfectly. And one time somebody was asking me about these different people, all these different teachers and everything. I said, well, they're all agents in my mind. And they're working perfectly where they are right now. But that takes it out of the context of trying to have an opinion about...
Right.
Da-da-da-da-da, and who's doing this and this and that.
Yeah.
It's all a reflection of mine.
Yeah, they can all be saying different things and yet all be right on for their particular audiences because they're really talking.
Yes, the bridge.
At different levels. You know,
the bridge is established.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's an interesting world.
If they're doing what Holy Spirit calls them to do, then they're doing it just perfect. That's right. And if you want to reach the masses today, you know, you have to sit with Oprah. And Marianne, you know, they
and Marianne
sit with...
is in contact with her. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, in Carrie's book, the teacher said that too. They call her the holy rap artist, Marianne Williamson. Mm-hmm. But they did acknowledge that she'll probably reach more people in numbers than anyone else because at the level that she's available, there are more people that will listen to her at this point.
Yeah, even for that, it's stepping stones because I was talking to somebody recently and who was really involved with Marianne's work and they said, well, there was that phase that she was on Oprah and everything, but then there was a bit of a falling out where Marianne had contacted him and Oprah just said, no, I'm not interested in going further with this, publicizing any more books or this and this. But again, all things work together for good, so, you know, it's always like you can't push the river.
Right.
You can just be grateful for everything that happens and just say, see the glory in that. And lots of them, like Wayne Dyer over the years, is now, you know, getting more into the course, and it's just been. Jerry Jampolsky has written so many of those books that have been translated. Very simple books with little caricatures and everything.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know several people that started out with His Love is Letting Go of Fear. Mm-hmm. That was where they started. And then later they wanted to find out where he got that stuff from. And then they finally went to the course. After.
Mm-hmm. Never looked any further.